All right, well, it's Saturday. That means it's wedding day, and we are on our way to St. Anne's Catholic Church in Pensacola. We've been there before. I've actually done a middle school prom there for the last 3 years, so the venue is going to look familiar to you. But now, let me just explain to you about what we're going to be doing tonight. We're going to be on the stage, because if you remember back at the gig log with the middle school prom, they had a stage, and they're going to set us up on the stage. I've already talked to the wedding coordinator about that. And we're going to be doing some uplighting. We're going to have the gobo projector. We're also going to be spotlighting the cake again, like we did that wedding a few weeks ago. So you'll get to see that. So anyway, there's really not much more to say other than that. It's going to be a fun group. I can already tell by the way the bride's been talking about them and the music choices they've got. So we're definitely going to have a great time tonight. And Meg's with me. She just got here from Mobile. Hey, Meg.
Hey.
Yeah, we're having a great time, and we're going to go ahead and get set up here in just a little bit, and I'll be talking to you once we get set up. Okay, I'm standing in the middle of the dance floor, and like I said, we've been here before. We were just here a couple months ago and did the middle school prom. I've done that for like the last 3 years, but things are set up a little bit differently tonight. However, I am set up in the same spot right there on the stage. Only difference is last time we were here a couple months ago, we did the middle school prom. I had the new RCF powered speakers. We got the older JBLs back tonight because we need a little bit more power for that. So we got the old JBLs and the old QSC amp that I was using all the way up. Well, for about the last 10 years or so, but anyway, they're great speakers, and we're glad that they're able to be used tonight. So anyway, I got the monogram over there. You can't really see it that well, but it's right there shining back over this way on the dance floor. And then also we got that extra par can that I got. I got that last time I did a wedding. I showed you how we spotlighted the cake, and so we got that spotlighting the cake over there, so I thought that's going to look really nice. We do have some uplighting around the room too, but you just really can't see all that right now just because this is still light in here. You can start seeing a little bit over there. But now one thing, and I'm going to post this to my Facebook page here in a little bit, is that they actually used about four of my uplights for the ceremony at another church. They're actually getting married at a Baptist church, but we're at a Catholic church is where they're having the reception. So anyway, I took a couple of my uplights over there, about four of them, and put it up there for the ceremony. So they're actually going to be bringing those back to me here in a little bit, so we'll have a little bit more uplighting in a little while once they bring those lights. So anyway, I've worked with this wedding coordinator before, so I trust him with bringing my lights back. So anyway, he's a great guy, and I'm really looking forward to working with him tonight. So anyway, we'll be getting things started here in just a little bit, and we'll be talking to you throughout the night.
Thank you.
up and dancing now. It's about 10:20 and we're supposed to go till midnight tonight. Okay, I just wanted to do the final wrap for this wedding gig log that you just saw from right here in the Oval Office. First of all, I want to say that was a wonderful bride and groom I had the chance to work with. The bride and I had been planning this for months. And also, their wedding coordinator was a lot of fun as well. I had done another wedding with him back in early May. And he's just really laid back, just a great guy. And he's actually from Atlanta and does a lot of weddings here in Pensacola. So we've had the chance to work together before. And just a great guy. And I would recommend him to any bride who's looking for a wedding coordinator. Now, with that said, let's talk a little bit about the wedding itself. Everything went great, and the wedding coordinator actually asked me to do a little bit of uplighting at the church, and I didn't get any video on that because I didn't have my video camera with me, but I do have a still photo that I could show you from the uplighting that I did there. I just took about four uplights and just went and put them behind the pulpit there where they were getting married, and it just made all the difference in the world. So anyway, that was a great addition for the bride and groom as well, and I know that they were grateful for that. We also did the monogram, and we also did a spotlight on the cake, which was really neat. Now, I put the monogram on the wall because it really didn't look right as it sat there on the dance floor, and everything just went smoothly from there, and it was just a great event altogether. Now, the one thing that we had a little bit of confusion toward the end, and what happened is that I was under the impression that the reception ended at midnight, but actually, come to find out, we had to be out of there at midnight. So the wedding coordinator came up to me about 11:15 and said, we have to be out of here by midnight. So anyway, Meg and I were there rushing to get everything broken down, but she was a real big asset to me. I tell you what, once we started breaking everything down at 11:15, I was already working on the sounds equipment and everything, and she was going around getting the uplights around the room and putting them where they need to be. So you know what, I'm glad she was there to help me out, because I don't know if I could have broken down that quickly and gotten everything out of there. But we did get everything broken down by midnight. It was actually 12:15 before we got out of there, but that was no big deal. You know, we got everything done, and we were out of there pretty quickly. And also, we used the big JBL speakers for this particular wedding, and the reason for that was because this bride was going to have over 300 people there. And having done another event with the RCF speakers in that same room just a couple months ago, I really thought we'd be better off having the bigger JBLs, and they seemed to work out great, so that worked out really well, and glad that we used those. But the JBLs are back in storage now, and probably won't be using those for a while, so we'll be back to using the RCFs in the next gig logs that you'll be seeing. The future gig logs, at least for the time being, until further notice. So anyway, glad to know that I've got those JBLs, but tell you what, since I've gone with the powered RCFs, I'm really glad that I don't have to use the JBLs every time, for every gig. That really makes things a whole lot easier, and it helps out not having to carry the big heavy amp around as well. So anyway, that's where we're going to leave this. A wonderful bride and groom, wonderful wedding coordinator, just a positive evening all the way around, and they were a great couple to work with. So until next time, practice and enjoy.